right now we are in the friction stir welding facility of the Department of Mechanical Engineering at IIT Kharagpur. So I have with me over here the lead of this particular lab, Professor S.K. Pal. So here actually what we intend to do is to show you the use of cyber physical systems, the concept of cyber physical systems and IIoT over here. So these are, as we have seen in the previous lectures, that these are prime contributors to the development of Industry 4.0 concepts. So I have with me Professor S.K. Pal, who is going to explain how this kind of friction stir welding, a cyber physical system, works in practice. So just to give you a recap of how a cyber physical system works, so we have the physical system, that means the machine which is actually performing the work, and the cyber component, so working hand in hand. So we have different sensors that are equipped with this particular machine that we are going to show you now, and then these sensors, they collect a lot of data, and based on that there is some actuation that is performed, and also consequently some kind of control. So we have the sensing component, the computing component, and the control component all working hand in hand. So this is what the cyber physical system is, and this friction stir welding machine is a good example of this particular system, the cyber physical system. So these are actually prime contributors to the Industry 4.0 development. Professor Pal, could you please explain over here how this friction stir welding process works?
Yeah, thank you Professor Mishra. So friction stir welding is a solid state joining process. So it is the most advanced the joining technique, and it is quite different from this the fusion welding process, because in case of fusion welding you melt the material and then after that it gets out of the solidification we get the joint and all. So I'll quickly explain what is the process about. Let us take an example. If these two plates have to be joined, right. So they are placed side by side in a bar welding configuration, and we make use of this the tool. Tool has got a projected part which is called the pin, and then flat part which is called the solder. Okay, so the tool rotates and plunges into this the joining line until and unless this flat part touches on the top surface of the tool. Okay, so there is a friction between the flat part of the tool and the job surface. That's why the term is the friction is there. Friction is adding the heat, generation of the heat, and there is a plastic deformation because of the movement of the pin. Right. So the material from one side gets moved to the other one. So that's a stirring operation. So that's why the second name is there. And since there is a relative movement, so that the joining is taken place. So when the tool comes out, it leaves a hole over there. So the advantage of this process, as I mentioned, that there is no melting. So it's a solid state joining process. So a lot of industries have come forward and they've already started using it for different applications. If you look at this board, so there are applications like this Apple, the computer, they have welded the front part as well as the back part by the friction stir welding process. We have got the example of these high speed railway carriages. We have also got the example of the space shuttle. But all these, the examples, what we see is that from the industries which are abroad, in the outside, there is no Indian industry so far, that use this process. But there is a recent announcement by the chairman of the ISRO, Dr. Sivan Kohl, in the last, the satellite launching, that they are going to use this process to a large extent so that it helps in increasing the payload.
Wonderful.
Yeah. So the most, the beautiful example of this process is that, this automobile industry. Because there we need to always think for this lightweighting. So lightweighting means that the situation comes for the different dissimilar material welding. We have got several examples like aluminium and then steel. We have got the on different configuration, lap weld, bar weld. We have got the magnesium and then steel. We have also used this HDP, that is high density polyethylene, copper and aluminium, and also different configurations including this the pipe welding. So we have explored all this process, but
each and every industry these days is looking for this, you know, the compliance of the machine towards the industry 4.0. So for this compliance, the main thing is that, as you have mentioned, that the sensor, mm-hmm. sensor, we can engage different types of the sensors, right. which collects the data, and then we can work on that. But essentially, based on this, you know, the sensors information and your analysis, analytics, you have to control the process parameters, so the feedback loop is very much important over here. Right. So we have, you know, the come up with the module called this, you know, this online, the control, online monitoring, and then analysis, and then control. Everything is done on the cloud base. So in this particular machine, we have engaged, you know, the two types of the sensor. One is inbuilt, that is the load sensor. Right. So load sensor senses the you know, the force information. Okay. Because if during welding, if any defect comes up, so that will be reflection on the signature of this, you know, the force. And this, so this force sensor data is sent to the cloud. Mm-hmm. Similarly, we have also acquired the power sensor. Power is a direct, the power, it has got the direct indication about the defects. And also not only the defects, you know, we basically mean the type of the defects and also the severity of the defects. So depending on the you know, the different varieties of the defect, the signature gets changed, and also the severity of the defect, the signature gets changed. So we collected all these informations, and then we have sent it to the cloud. In the cloud we have got the decision, you know, the box, decision engine. So
basically the analytics is performed at the cloud.
You're absolutely right. And then based on that decision and the you know, which is taken in the cloud, out of the knowledge box existing over there, so the data is, I mean, information is, information comes from the cloud to the machine to change the parameter. Parameter means the welding parameter, the rotational speed, and also the linear speed, so that the defect gets.
So basically, the accuracy of the job can be controlled with the help of this entire feedback cycle.
Yeah, exactly. Because you know, for any manufacturing the process, or any if you like to study the performance of the product and the quality of the product, you always need to study the performance of the machine. Okay, even though you are setting the optimum parameter, you know that you are bound to get the good quality, but essentially you don't get it. So you always need to monitor the weld quality or the, you know, the product of the of any, you know, process, and accordingly you need to change the parameter so that it comes out essentially good, the product. So that's the essence of this Industry 4.0. So we have implemented that one to friction star welding process. We will have, you know, we are also working on that to a large extent, so that different machines can be connected to the cloud. So the knowledge of one machine can also be shared by the other machine, just like the human being, you know, interacting in the social media and
And that basically serves also the purpose of Industry 4.0,
yes,
where we need to have connectivity between the different
machines. Yeah. Because when you say the Industry 4.0, we essentially means that, you know, the performance of the different types of these, you know, the machines, and also how do they interact with the other machines, and also the supply chain line, that means how the, you know, in which sequence the material is coming up and then going out. So the entire chains, starting from the input, the raw material supply to the finished product, everything when it is connected to the cyber the system, then that will good connect between the cyber systems and the physical systems, and that essentially gives a very good Industry 4.0 compliant process.
So thank you so much. So can we have a look at
I'll request one of my doctoral scholars, Mr. Devasis Mishra. So Devasis Mishra works on this this Industry 4.0 the process devices. Yeah. So Mr. Devasis Mishra, you quickly run the machine, and we demonstrate that with the welding process, how the it will show the defects, and then essentially over the period of the time how the defect gets eradicated. Because when you say the joining process, it means the assembly of the different components and which might be processed to the other, you know, the manufacturing the techniques. So the quality the check on online basis is very, very important, otherwise there will be the rejection of the entire thing. So I Devasis, could you please quickly switch on the machine and then demonstrate the process, and We'd like to show, please show the how bad quality is getting changed and coming up with a good one.
So behind me, what you see over here is a is an indigenous friction stir welding machine, which can do friction stir welding on two different materials. So this particular machine is able to do linear jobs. That means that two different materials it can weld together in a linear fashion. So I have with me Mr. Devashish Mishra, who is a PhD scholar in this particular department, and he is going to explain to you how this particular machine works. But before that, let me just tell you that what is the whole purpose of showing this particular machine here. So we have studied about cyber physical systems and industrial IoT. So this is a good example of how cyber physical systems work. So as I told you before, that there is the cyber component and the physical component of these systems, which work hand in hand. So we have different sensors which basically sense different parameters, as Mr. Mishra will be explaining shortly. So these sensor parameters will be taken, and there is some computation that is done, and based on the computation there is some control that is also implemented on this particular system. So the sensing component, the computing and the control working together hand in hand, this is how this particular system works. So this is a good example of a cyber physical system in action, and these types of systems are very much important for industrial environments in the industry 4.0 scenarios. So Mr. Mishra, could you please explain the functionality of this particular machine?
Yes sir. So this is manufactured by Eaton Technologies Private Limited, and it's a 3-axis friction stir welder. So as you told, it has the capability to join similar as well as dissimilar materials. It has got a maximum rotational speed of 3000 rpm and the maximum traversing speed of 1000 rpm per minute. And with this machine, we have inbuilt load cells of 10 kN capacity each. So this gives us the forces in three direction as well as the torque in three direction. And apart from that, we have the speed sensor, which senses the rotational speed of the machine during the welding and the traverse speed. So apart from this rotational speed and traverse speed, we have two different parameters as well, the tilt angle and plunge depth. However, in this machine, we cannot control the gear. Now what?
So where are these sensors?
Real-time monitoring and control video of this part. So we have here two aluminium plates which have been placed very close to each other without maintaining any gap between them. And this is the tool which is going to weld these two materials.
So we have two materials which are aluminium, and this particular tool is a steel tool.
Yeah, this is H13.
Okay.
It's a chromium hardened tool steel, which has been fabricated as per the dimensions of the workpiece. So the thickness of this material is 2.5 mm. So we have a pin which is of length 2.2 mm. And this is the pin diameter is 5 mm. And we have this shoulder of 13 mm diameter.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we see how it works?
Yes. So this is the GUI which we have developed here. So I'm going to switch on the machine, which the machine should have run. And this is the remote control panel where I'm going to connect this facility. So I'm trying to connect this machine to my laptop.
Okay.
This is the remote control.
So basically with this you can remotely
access the machine.
You can control the machine also remotely.
Yes. So here initially we have set the rotational speed and traverse speed in such a way that we are bound to get some bad wind.
what you see is a vertical milling machine, a conventional, traditional vertical milling machine. Milling machines, as you know, are used for smoothening of some metal slips. This particular milling machine is something that has been transformed to a friction stir welding machine with the help of different technologies, which will be explained by Mr. Mahato, who is a PhD scholar in this particular lab. So, Mr. Mahato, could you please explain how this particular machine works?
This is a vertical manual milling machine, and this machine has got wide range of the sprinted speed, this machine has got wide table as well, and this table can carry the weight up to the 600 kg, the spindle RPM can be up to 31.5 RPM to 1800 RPM, and on the same time this table can move along X axis, Y axis, Z axis at the feed rate of 16 mm per minute to 1600 minute per minute. So with the help of this wide range of this spindle speed and the weight speed and its high weight carrying capacity, this machine can be used for the friction stir welding of similar and dissimilar material. And so far, we have converted this machine as a manual FSW machine, and we have performed FSW on aluminum sheet and also on aluminum steel dissimilar material sheet. For monitoring the welding process, we have integrated this machine with the same sensor, such as the piezoelectric dynamometer has been installed with this spindle. So by using this piezoelectric dynamometer during the welding, the forces acting on the tool and the moment, we can monitor. And on the same time, we have also integrated other sensors, such as thermocouples to measure the welding heat input, and by using the power sensor, we can measure the power, electric power consumed by this machine. So with the help of these data, such as the spindle force torque, welding heat input, and electric power consumption of this machine, we can monitor the weld quality. However, since this is not a CNC control machine, so this all data can be used after welding. So electric dynamometer has been connected with a charge amplifier, and this inside the piezoelectric dynamometer, few piezoelectric crystals are there. So whenever the spindle is experiencing some sort of the force, electric voltage is getting generated on those piezoelectric crystals, and by using sensors, that voltage we are recorded by using our computer.
Thank you.